Om Namah Shivaya. Namaste everyone. Today we will try to understand what is the fourth step in Ashtanga Yoga. The first one Yam, second Niyam, third Asan, I explained you last time. And today we will see the fourth one, which is Pranayama. Yam, Niyam, Asan, Pranayama. Pranayama is made by two Sanskrit words, pran and ayam. Pran means the life force. Pran means not air. Pran means not air. Pran means the air which you breathe. So it becomes life force. It gives us the energy to live, energy to be alive. I am means to extend something to one certain level. And there is another meaning of I am, to suspend something. So extension of breathing. When I practice pranayama, I try to bring deep breathing, and then that oxygen will be mixing up in my blood, and the oxidized blood will go through my body. That's how the body works. But normally we say deep breathing, let the breathing go around the different corners of your body. That's how it works, because in the blood it goes. Breathing directly cannot go in your arms, in your legs. Breathing has a way to go. It mixes up in the blood and then it travels. And I am, to suspend, what does that mean? This is a simple meaning, extension. Some people are not getting enough blood circulation in their toes, they get some skin disease. We suggest them to practice pranayama and then they get relief. But what is the meaning of suspension? Let me tell you one story. It will be easy for you to understand. In an ancient time, a great warrior in India called Chhatrapati Shivaji. One of his warriors was fighting with enemies, and enemy was chasing him. He had no way, and then he entered in a cave, maybe just like this, and he find a shelter. There was a sage practicing meditation. When he heard some sound, and then he opened the eyes and asked him, "Who are you? Where are you coming from?" Then the warrior said, "I am the warrior of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, and I am here to save myself because enemy is chasing me." Then the sage asked, "Who is Chhatrapati Shivaji?" The warrior was very surprised, because he said, "This is his kingdom. You are sitting here. He is the king of this place." The sage said, "Last time I opened my eyes, 1700 years ago, the warrior could not believe a person can stay alive for that long. 1700 years he didn't open the eyes. What about the food and drink?" So the warrior said, "So master, are you sitting here for 1700 years The sage said, "No. Before that I opened my eyes 5000 years ago." And then he definitely could not believe that. So this is the meaning of suspension of breathing. One breath you take and suspend the breathing, suspend the heartbeat. whatever the amount of oxygen is taken in one breath is enough for 1700 years. The amount of oxygen what you have taken is enough for 5000 years. Maybe it's unbelievable to hear, but let me give you one example. Can you hold your breath for 1 minute? With some practice, you will say yes. How about 5 minutes? You will say, nah, that's a bit difficult, but not impossible. How about 1 hour? Oh, that's impossible. How about for 1 day? No, it's no way. So you can afford 1 minute, but you cannot afford 1 day. Exactly, if you can afford $1, you cannot afford $1 million because you don't have it. When you will have 1 million, you will be able to afford $1 million as well. Today you can afford $1 for anything easily. Exactly the same way we can afford 1 minute today, because that is our limit. We don't have that richness for $1 million. So we can't think about holding the breath for 1 day. We can't think about holding the breath for 1700 years. That's how pranayama can take form. It can go beyond the life, beyond the death. There is no limit of life and death after that, when you reach that level of pranayama. There are numerous type of pranayamas. When you will try to search the names, how to breathe and when to breathe, there are so many different type of pranayama. But let me tell you, the most important functions, the steps of pranayama are Rechan, Kumbhak. Rechan means breathe out. Kumbhak means holding. And Kumbhak can be two type, Bahya Kumbhak and Antya Kumbhak. Bahya Kumbhak means holding the breath outside. Antya Kumbhak means holding the breath inside. Just focus on these basic principles of pranayama and you will reach the ultimate state of breathing, ultimate state of meditation. Rechan means let all the negative energy go out through the breathing. Not only the breathing. Why do we practice breathing? Because there must be a purpose. There is so much stress. There is so much negativity in our personality, in our behavior, in our mind, in the body. We have to remove it away. And pranayama is a way. Pranayama is a way to help us to get mental health. I hope you will get the basic idea from this lecture, and don't forget to subscribe the channel and like the video. If you have any question, just write down below and I will try my best to answer you. Thank you so much and I will see you around.